Ladies and gentlemen, Nigerians and Nigerians, students and students, welcome to Battle of the Unis! Introducing your host, all the way from Ogun State, Nigeria, Favour Amubode!
Welcome everyone to Battle of the Unis! I'll be your host for today, Favour Amubode. Now, a few weeks ago, we reached out to 5 students from top federal universities in the great country of Nigeria. All they had to do was prove that their universities are not only worthy of being part of the top 5, but also the best of the best. Now, these universities are the University of Ibadan, Nigeria, the University of Ilorin, Nigeria, the University of Nigeria, Nsukka, Nigeria, Obafemi Awolowo University, Ile-Ife, Nigeria, and the last but definitely not the least, the University of Lagos, Nigeria. I know you're all eager to jump into the rules of the battles and let's get this show on the road. But before we move ahead of ourselves, let us meet our amazing, spectacular, and superb representatives.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sinmi. I'm from OAU. I'm in my final year studying economics. And I just want to tell you guys about my school and how it is better than your school in like various aspects. So sit tight and listen as I go on.
Hey guys, I'm Josh and I'm a student of University of Ilorin. I feel comparing any school and thinking any school in Nigeria is better than Ilorin seems illegal. Like, how do you in good conscience say that there is a school in this Nigeria that is better than University of Ilorin? I can't get my head around it. Ilorin is not just called better by far to be disrespected like this, to be compared with all this. Please, the second position, fight for it.
Hey guys, I'm David and I'm a student of the University of Ibadan. Yes, it is certain that University of Ibadan stands out as the best of all Nigerian universities, and that's why anything you are involved in is always characterized by greatness, excellence, uniqueness, quality, anything, name it. I rep the first and the best university. Watch out.
My people, my name is Amarachi, I'm the 211th student of the University of Nigeria, Nsukka. Department of Economics, Faculty of Social Sciences. If you're not yet a student of UNN, you're missing that. UNN is not just called the best for nothing. Oh God, it's like a whole new world. You're going to love it. If you're not yet a lion of my knees, just start getting yourself in. Start warming your baby, because you can't give my hell.
Hi, what's up? My name is Just Ed. I rep Unilag, University of Lagos, the University of First Choice. Yeah, I'm an artist. I study theater arts and I'm in 300 here. What's there not to like about Unilag? I mean, it's Unilag. Yeah, I'm telling you now, so before we get into this, you know Unilag is the best, number one. Nothing.
I'm sure you guys are feeling the heat right now and I really can't wait to get the show on the road. So down to the rules of the contest. Each representative was asked to make 3 short videos of about 30 seconds each as to why their university is the best in the area of transportation, food and social activities. Each category carries a total of 10 points, which brings it to 30 points overall. However, this point will be converted to percentage, which means that the school with the highest percentage wins the ultimate bragging rights. Ladies and gentlemen, the final decision is all down to one judge and that is not me. Ladies and gentlemen, judging this battle is none other than a senior secondary school student whose next stage in life is the university, and he just wants to be impressed. Ladies and gentlemen, I present the judge for Battle of the Unis, David Albert.
I'm David, I'm in senior secondary school, and I'm going to be the judge for the Battle of the Unis. I want to be impressed. I also want to vibe with you guys a lot. And I want you guys to understand that no matter what happens in this Battle of the Unis, it shouldn't change anything. Your schools are big schools, legendary schools, so let's just have fun and just compete. Have good sense of sportsmanship and everything. So, thank you.
You know the rules, you've met the judge, you've seen the contestants. Now, let the battle begin. Kicking it off with the first category, transportation. Let's see what these representatives have to say.
Transportation. We have the best transportation. Sorry, you want to argue with me? Argue with your ancestor. Argue with your ancestor. Your ancestor. My guy, if you're coming into Unilag, there's a bus stop. Phase 2 takes you straight into school. And when you get to school, you enter your public transport. Sharp, sharp, you get to where you want on time.
Yeah. Oh, on time!
My bad. That's it.
Number one is our transportation. I don't know about other universities, but we have like the best.
We have like the best
transportation here in my school. We have a bus that carries us from gates to our bus stop for just 30 naira. And we have this SUV bus that will carry us for 20 naira, and it's like very comfortable. And we have bikes too to take us anywhere on campus, no matter how far or deep it is, just for 50 naira. Imagine 50 naira. Bere.
UI has the best transport services. The cabs in UI are very clean, neat, and of course affordable. Imagine that anywhere in UI can take a cab for 30 naira. Yes, it's as cheap as that. When you take drop in UI, you feel like a king. Even boats can't beat it. Yes. You know, we have Keke Marua in other schools. In UI, we have standard tricycle services. One good thing about UI's transport services is that cabs are accessible everywhere in UI. We have buses, we have cheap transportation.
When we talk of UNI transportation, it's the best of its kind, It's highly affordable, it's very cheap, and prices are fixed. They are coordinated, they are organized. I know you don't know that the buses are not allowed to run in certain places of school. Ask me why. The reason is to reduce the risk of accident because of the influx of students in those areas. On top of coordination, they have parks, and they don't park anywhere outside the parks. That is for the safety of the students. I represent University of Nigeria, Nasuka.
Transportation is like a very big issue when we talk about schools in Nigeria generally. But here in Ilorin, it's so easy. You don't have to worry about how to get to school or how to come back before leaving. That stress, that mental stress is not there. And the fact that you pay as little as 30 naira to get into the school, and you can even sit just three in a row. I think that's amazing. I doubt there's any school in Nigeria that can offer that much.
Win this round, don't hesitate to place your guesses. And while we do that, let's see what Judge David has to say.
Transportation. Unilorin gave me points, like good convincing points about the 30 naira and the 3 naira store, and students not having to bother about transportation in their school. But you didn't state whether or not those transportation vehicles, the vehicles that would be used for transportation, would actually be available in any part of the campus. So that's why I gave Unilorin 8. OAU gave me good points, convincing points. The bikes and everything, the shuttle buses available everywhere on campus and everything. OAU 9. UNN. I'm giving UNN 8. She actually gave me a very convincing and very strong point. She said there are some areas in the school where vehicles are not allowed to move because of the influx of students to reduce the risks of accidents. And that is something every school should be thinking about. What if a car hits a student? What if this happens? What if that happens? Exactly. So that was why I gave UNN a 10. Not only that, she told me some things and I actually got confused. So Unilag, like I said in the intro video, I would like to vibe with you guys and everything. So I was rather looking for points, not only vibes, but some points too, strong points. But Unilag didn't give me points that would actually convince me or anything about the transportation. So that's why I'm giving Unilag 7. UI also stated the same points as OAU, so I'm giving UI a 9.
So after the result from this first round, it places the University of Lagos in 5th place, Unilori in 4th, OAU and UI are tied at 2nd, and the University of Nigeria, Nsukka, shines gloriously in 3rd. However, do know that can change in the next round. But before we jump into it, it's time for a quick commercial break. We'll be right back.
Hello everyone, I am Faith and I am very pleased to announce that I will be collaborating with Favour Amubode for our next month's You, Me and Them series. Yes. First of all, I must say a very big thank you to Favour for requesting that we have this collaboration, because I really enjoyed the first series and I'm really glad that I get to be a part of the second series. The topic for next month's series is African parenting. Yes, we are going to be shaking a lot of tables, and of course there are three perspectives. I will not be telling you the perspective that I will be focusing on, which is why I need you to watch all three videos that Favour is going to be releasing. I promise that you are going to enjoy them and in fact learn a lot from them, honestly. So yeah, we are really glad and I can't wait to watch the videos. Thank you.
Still battle of the unis, and I am still your wonderful host, Favour Amubode. Now take a look again at the scoreboard so you will know what to do in this next round and how hard you'll be praying for your universities, because we're going into food. Let's see what your representatives had to say, shall we?
Of course, UI has the best food services. If you think your school has better food services, you've probably not heard of the one and only Bollywood restaurant. Ugh, how I miss Bollywood restaurants. With 200 naira, you can feed for an entire semester. UI's food is not only sweet, it's delicious, affordable, classy, everything. It's just the best. I was in a school one day, I tried out their food. It was blah!
Terrible.
About feeding, less about food. The cost of living in Ilorin is very, very good, actually, very low. As a student, you can eat comfortably with 200 naira and you'll be satisfied. There'll be meat, I'm telling you. Yeah, show me a place in this country, a school in this country that you can survive with such amount of money. I mean, why in Ilorin?
The food in UNN, there are a lot of restaurant eateries. Literally all departments have their canteens, even the faculties. Where you eat, the environment is super clean. It's very, very clean. Very, very clean. It's always good. Then when we talk of the food, fruits are very fresh and cheap. It's very cheap. Then when we have food vendors, for those of us that don't like wasting money, you can get food with the last you tonight of 200 naira. Snacks assorted, like breads of. After giving you the food, they give you water to wash it down.
Let's talk about food. Cheeseless. We have curry this bag. We have chef food. See, you want me to keep mentioning, because if you don't know these two, you are lying. Listen well, you are lying if you don't know Korean Spag and Chef Food. I can't even mention all of them. I mean, all of them. Good food. Man, if they we gather again, we stand.
Stand.
I beg, come out. Best food in the lab. Alright.
Our food. Gosh, There's nowhere on our campus that you will not find something reasonable to eat. Like confirm food, not just snacks or anything. Anywhere on our campus, no matter how far your department is or your hostels, you will definitely find one place that you eat reasonable food. And they are very, you know, and very sweet, yummy. You'll be filled up.
I'm sure you guys prayed hard for this round, yeah? But still, it's all down to the judge at the end of the day. So let's see what he has to say. That rhymes.
Feeding. I'll start with Unilori again. Unilori actually gave me good points. The point that it was actually affordable. What I was looking for was whether or not the food could be available anywhere on campus to the students, everywhere. So that's why I'm giving Unilori a 7. Oh, you gave me points. Good points. It's been available anywhere on campus, affordable, it's good, it's delicious, and everything, reasonable food. So that's why I'm giving OAU a 9. UNN actually gave me good points. The feeding area was good. There are waste bins. Everything is super clean. If you don't want to waste money, there are vendors everywhere where you will get good food for children area. So that's why I'm giving UNN 10. Unilag, like I said earlier, I'm looking for vibe, but I'm also looking for points too. So Unilag didn't hit the nail on the head and everything. So I'm going to give Unilag a 6. UI gave me good points, the public restaurants and everything. Students could be able to survive a whole semester with just 200 naira and everything. So we're actually stating the same points as Unilorin, so that's why I'm giving UI a 7.
So that means that UNN still stays firmly on top, while the tie between OAU and UI has finally been broken, with OAU having the better end, taking the second place and UI being third. Unilorin still remains fourth and Unilag is still striving at fifth. But before you start placing bets on who wins, hold your horses, because it's time for the final round. Ladies and gentlemen, let us go social. Let's see what your amazing representatives have to say about social activity.
When you mention social events in UI, no school can beat UI social events. UI sets the pace for other Nigerian universities. I mean, UI party a lot, the vibe is always there, celebrities come for our parties, what else, mention it. There's always a large turnout for our events. And when you talk about dinners, they are usually very standard. They set the standard for other universities. When you say UI is the first and the best, it's not just the first and the best in academics, social life, food, transport, everything.
Social activities, meaning that comes on top. Sorry, what? On top. We even have the one that Unilag itself runs, entertainment. Come on, it's always lit. I can still remember when CDQ came and the whole thing turned to a mosh pit. Which school has mosh pit? If you don't know mosh pit, you're squeezing dead school. If you're squeezing dead school. I'm sorry, y'all not social. Best social activities, Unilag.
And the main of all, our social activities, our school is paramount. Once our school resumes, like, there is literally no week that there won't be one confirmed party. No house party, be our own. Okay. As universities, our own party is dope. Thank. And even the artists that our school has produced alone. Say it's Fireboy or Yemuli or Black Bones or Chinko Ekun or Yemele Show. I can't keep on mentioning them.
Them plenty.
Just, you can even check the net. You see them there.
Social activities now. Almost every week there's an artist or a celebrity on campus. Students are not just choked with book. And you sometimes you wonder, is Unilorin an ambassador to these celebrities? All African Games, for example, now has been hosted by Unilorin for like 3 years in a row. That says something about this school. Unilorin is not just called better by far to be disrespected like this, to be compared with all this.
Please, the second position, fight for it.
social activities. After too much reading and all that, you don't forget to shake it off. When we just talk of parties, my dear, just the awareness alone, it's just as if the party already began. The turn up, like everywhere is free. Do you even know that they hold parties like virtually every weekend? So you don't even have to miss out. At times, celebrities will come around. It's legalized.
It's legalized.
Like, when we talk of social.
Let's go social. So let's have a quick reminder of the scoreboard. If your university is not the one on top, you guys better start crossing your fingers and hoping they score high in this round, because whatever goes in this round will determine who gets the ultimate bragging right. But before we go into the judges' statement for this final round, ladies and gentlemen, we have a special entertainment package for our awesome audience and amazing viewers back at home. Ladies and gentlemen, I present Sharon.
I won't just survive. Oh, you will see me thrive. Can write my story. I'm beyond the archetype. I won't just conform. No matter how you shake my coin, 'cause my roots they run deep. Oh, your soul is great. Don't doubt it. Victory is in my vein. I know it. And I will not negotiate. I'll fight it. I will transform. Away from the fire that might hit again. And the vultures all start.
Sharon, that was an amazing performance. Now, the moment we've all been waiting for. Which school is gonna go home with the ultimate bragging rights? Let's just see what Judge David had to say about social activities.
And the social activities, this was the easiest to judge. Every school gave the same points. That's why I'm giving OAU, UNN, UI, Unilorin, and Unilag.
I know you guys have already started placing bets, seeing as we didn't let you guys into what the judge final scoring were. However, I want you guys to know that I have the answers right here. So ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor of letting you guys know which university goes home with the ultimate bragging rights. Let's do this, shall we? In fifth place, after bagging 8 points in the final round and with a total of 70%. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, going on with the fifth position today is the University of Lagos, Lagos, Nigeria. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big thumbs up to University of Lagos, represented by Just Ed. He did a spectacular job. Lord knows I can't do what he did, and I'm really, really grateful. You gave it your all, and fifth is not a bad number. Thank you. Moving on to the fourth position. With a total of 80%, and after bagging a whooping 9 in the final round, ladies and gentlemen, coming in fourth is the better by far University, University of Ilori, Ilori, Nigeria. A big thank you to George for representing his university. You did an amazing job, and you are amazing, Josh. Now we are down to the top three. The university going home with a third place trophy after scoring 9 points in the final round with a total of 83.3%. Ladies and gentlemen, coming in third is the first and the best university, University of Ibadan, Ibadan, Nigeria. Congratulations, UI, and thanks you so much, David, for representing your university. Once again, you did a splendid job, and Lord knows you are spectacular. Thanks once again. So guys, I can feel the tension eating up right now. Who goes on with the ultimate bragging rights? Let's do this, shall we? I will have you all know that in the final round, these two universities both scored equal points of 9. However, there can only be one winner. Ladies and gentlemen, Nigerians and Nigerians, students and students, individuals and individuals, the university that came out top, the winner of the Battle of the Units, the one that proved to be the best of the best, and the school to be dazzled with the ultimate bragging rights is the University of Nigeria. Nigeria, represented by Amarachi. Congratulations, you deserve it. You did a spectacular job, and your points were spot on. And also to Babemi Awolowo University, good job for coming in second with 90%, and you definitely did a spectacular job as well. Thank you so much, Sinmi. I'm really grateful to all the representatives, and I'm grateful to everyone that made Battle of the Unis a reality. This was really a spectacular time. It was an amazing period. I'm so sure ULA people will be jubilating right now. You guys deserve it. You guys did well, and you guys, you know, should watch out because people are coming for those bragging rights, trust me. So a big thank you to our audience and awesome viewers back at home. Thank you so much for staying tuned with Battle of the Unis. It was really a pleasure having you guys onto this, and I'm so sure you guys are expecting another special rendition which will be coming soon. Thanks so much for watching. Once again, I am your host, Favour Amubode. Thank you, and see you guys soon. Bye-bye.